I had wasted too much time yesterday. I wanted to cover it up, but Baroda was too hot and I could leave only by 12:31. By the time I exited Baroda, it was 1:30. Thankfully, the roads were good, and up till Ahmedabad, even Gandhinagar, it was a smooth ride on the lavish 6-lane expressways of Gujarat. There were times where I was touching 100-110 with ease. The only problem was the heat. The heat was terrible. It was dry heat and I was dehydrated. Every half an hour I was finishing 6 to 7 bottles every 2 to 3 hours, and it was horrible to say the least. The plan was to reach Ajmer by 10 PM, but the problem started once I started exiting Gujarat. I had heard that Rajasthan roads are good. Yes, the Rajasthan roads are good, but the weather, I could not take it. I had been through 7 states already and different temperature ranges. Rajasthan just suddenly hit me on my face. Yes, I also crossed the Tropic of Cancer on the way, which was a good feeling. I would not lie about that, but as soon as I started entering Rajasthan, the dust, the heat, and the poor visibility on the roads started affecting me. I was supposed to reach Udaipur by 6:30, which was not possible. I was so tired by the time I reached Udaipur, which was around 7:30, 7:45 I think, that I decided to take a halt there, because it was impossible to ride on those roads in the night. As you can see, it was under construction. They were converting the 2-lane into 3-lane, 2 or 3-lane highway, and the dust was unbearable. I had to wipe my visor every 15-20 minutes, and in the night, in the strong headlights of the vehicle, the dust just makes it impossible for you to see properly. I had no other option but to stop. It was totally out of the plan. The plan was to reach Ajmer or Jaipur, but I was around 500 kilometers short, and I had at most traveled only 6 hours that day and covered 400 kilometers. So now I stood at around 2600 kilometers in 72 hours, which was not the plan. I had not expected the weather to play such a spoiled sport. And by the time I checked into a small hotel in Udaipur, I realized my saddle bags had torn. When I was bending my bikes on the turns, the tire was touching the saddle bags and saddlebag was torn. Some of my clothes were also torn. They were burnt, to be precise. And I was trying to stitch them together throughout the night. It took me almost 3-4 hours. By the time I slept, it was 1 AM. And I wanted to get up early and start, and it seemed impossible. I needed sleep, I needed good food, and I needed to stitch up my bag. I wanted to give up, to be honest. And I just roam around in Udaipur and enjoy whatever I have done till now. But it was not painful, but just the idea of continuing was horrible because the heat was unbearable. The dehydration was taking effect and my saddlebag was torn. Shit.
I woke up at 7 and I left.
I had only one aim in mind today, to cover around 900 kilometers.
I didn't know how,
but I had. I did not have any other option. Oh, thankfully, till noon the weather was awesome. The roads were superb and I just kept on going. The first stop I took was around 250 kilometers from Udaipur. And thereafter, another 1 hour, I stopped for breakfast at a small dhaba. I had made up my mind that I would not stop at all till I reached at least Jaipur. Amazing how when you tell your mind that you have to do it, it does it. There's no stopping you. And that morning I realized that it was necessary. Otherwise, I would have failed the challenge in its entirety and it would have been a shameful act. As the sun slowly started rising up, the ride was probably a bit more strenuous. But I think up till Ajmer it was perfectly fine. Once I crossed Ajmer, that is when the problem started. The Ajmer-Jaipur highway is well laid out but filled with trucks, lots of dust. And again, dehydration starts affecting you. Jana padega. By 12:30, 12:45, it was clear that I had to stop every half an hour to have water and pulled on my bike. Else we both would have succumbed to the extreme heat. I reached Jaipur around at 2 PM and I left Jaipur at around 3:30. I wanted to give my body good rest before it crossed Haryana from Rajasthan. Again, just terrible. The heat, the dust. The fatigue levels were really high. I was almost 90 hours into the ride and there was no back pain as such, but it was all me feeling that fluids inside me have stopped working. I don't know. Had just vanished. Stopping every half an hour to 45 minutes was an utmost necessity by now. I did not want to enter Delhi, so I took a diversion towards Rewari, which was not a calculated risk because I got lost inside Rewari for almost half an hour. The roads were small and I got scared, to be honest, because I planned to reach Panipat or Chandigarh at least by 9 and I don't know, but I didn't stop. That was the best part. I had made up my mind once I left in the morning.
that I have to reach either Panipat or Chandigarh. It would have been better if it was Chandigarh, but the last 60 kilometers till Panipat, the highway was really awesome, and I just throttled my way up all the way there. Then the last 90 kilometers were covered in around 50 minutes or so. The highway was very good. Reaching Panipat meant the world to me that day because I had wasted so much time in the previous 2 days. But today, I covered more than what was expected. I would have liked if it was, you know, Chandigarh, a good 100 kilometers more, but, you know, all wells that ends well. I was hoping to get really good sleep and continue my way up all the way to Srinagar the day after. That was the plan, but you know what I've seen in the past 96 hours or so is whatever we plan, it does not reflect in reality. Just hoping that I can hit Srinagar or at least the Jawahar Tunnel by tomorrow. So let's see what is in store for us. Overall, a good day, 3,420 kilometers in 96 hours. Couldn't have asked for more. And the bike is holding up good. It's a thing I've noticed, especially in the noon, it tends to heat up more, which is quite obvious. By the time the evening temperatures are down, the bike is more smooth. I haven't changed the oil till now because I had used a very high grade synthetic oil in Trivandrum, so it's going, it's smooth and it's no issue. And right now I'm probably at the best state of mind possible because tomorrow is when I hit Jammu, tomorrow is when I hit Kashmir, tomorrow is when the challenge will be completed. Tomorrow is going to be a huge day. It's going to be crazy. I started out knowing not what I'll do, but now the goal, the aim is right in front of me and I know what to do. And I don't have words to say something. I just hope I get good sleep, that's it. Today was the last day and I took over another 650 to cross the Jawahar Tunnel and another 860 or to reach Srinagar, but the aim was to go further than that and reach Kargil by sunset. I crossed Karnal, Kurukshetra within 2 hours after I left. Ambala was another 2.5 hours. Crossing the Haryana-Punjab border was a few good factor. I think by 3 hours 15 minutes I had crossed Chandigarh and I was on my way to Ludhiana. Today nothing could have stopped me. Not the heat, not the roads, not my tiredness, not the bike. There was only one thing in my mind: cross the Jawahar Tunnel in time to see Srinagar and probably cross Sonmark and Kargil by sunset. My 4,000 kilometers would have anyways been done the moment I crossed Udhampur. The spirits were really high. I don't know how. My body was tired. My eyes were closing, but there was something that was pushing. It is something I cannot explain at all. Nothing seemed like an obstacle at all. And the moment I crossed Pathankot and I was nearing Jammu, it was 2 hours past noon, and I knew I had to push further because there was a stretch of bad roads from Udhampur to Banihal, which was prone to terrorist attacks as well, and I had to clear it before evening came in. Srinagar was the destination I was looking forward to. It didn't seem so far away, but what happens is when you look at the distance on the roads, on the highway, your mind tends to give up or relax. That is what I was trying to fight. That is what I was trying to overcome. Of course, the Jammu-Udhampur highway was beautiful, and by 3 p.m. I had done 4,000 kilometers. That was 118 hours for 4,000 kilometers. The challenge had been done, but I wanted to reach Srinagar before 5. But I reached by 6, which was again around 4,325 kilometers. It was tiring. The saddlebags had worn out, my shoes had worn out, my gloves had worn out, the jacket was old, the jacket was dusty, but I guess that day nothing would have stopped me because I didn't want to stop. Nothing at all. If there wasn't a way, I was making a way. If there wasn't a road, I was still traveling. I guess I was finally at peace with myself. Now they say, with great pain, you should do greater work. This was something that I needed to do when I was doing it. All along, I was just waiting for the tunnels to come. That was the indication that I had entered Kashmir. Driving, but there was no sign of it. The distances were not nearing, and it seemed probably I would not hit Srinagar by 5 or even 5:36, 6:37. And then finally I saw it, and it felt like heaven. The Charai Nashri Tunnel, I think it's beautifully built. The moment you enter it, you realize that you are gonna come out on the other side. The Jawahar Tunnel, very small, it's freezing inside, but the moment you enter outside, there's a huge pillar which says, "This is the first view of Kashmir. Park your bike and enjoy it." And I did. It was crazy. Jawahar Tunnel gives you the first view of Kashmir. I had around 45 minutes more. It was 4:40 or 4:45, I think, and I had to stop before the sun set because it's not a great road and a great area to travel
alone.
And
having reached Srinagar by 5:45, it was a great feeling. Looking over the Dal Lake, it was empty somehow, maybe because of Ramadan, but it felt awesome.
I'd finally done it.
4,325 kilometers in 120 hours.
It felt like heaven. Kashmir actually felt like heaven to me. I felt like, why the fuck was I even crying or being sad or being depressed? There's so much to do in life. There's always so much to do in life. I was overwhelmed. I cried probably crossing Srinagar Sonmark Highway. It felt awesome. Couldn't have been better than this. Challenge was accepted. And challenge was completed. We'll be right back. Having completed the challenge, the last one day I completely enjoyed myself traveling around the valleys of Kashmir, Leh and all. Ladakh, my battery died down and the phone just switched off. Heading back from Manali to Chandigarh, just felt awesome. I was sad that the trip was ending, and at the same time, I was very happy that I'd done something really great. And by the time I reached Delhi on my bike, my junior was waiting there to celebrate it with me. It was an awesome feeling hearing people talk about it and how difficult it was. But the fact was that I had enjoyed it, and it had completely changed me. दर्द तो सबको होता है, दर्द जिंदगी का एक अहम हिस्सा है। हम जितना दर्द से भागेंगे, दर्द उतना ही पीछे आएगा। दर्द का सामना करो, दर्द से गले मिलो, दर्द से हाथ मिलाओ, क्योंकि जब तक दर्द को तुम अपना दोस्त नहीं बनाओगे, वो तुम्हें छोड़ेगा नहीं। Every single time you are in pain, try and get out of your comfort zone. Do things which you would not normally do. It'll make you a better person. It'll make you more brave. It'll make you a human being. And it'll teach you how to deal with pain. Get the fuck out of your comfort zone.
Afraid our aim is out of sight. Wanna see you.